Good morning, friends. Welcome in this class. This is class 7, subject social science, and today we are going to study about our geography chapter 2, Inside Our Earth. It is the third lecture of this chapter, and in our previous lectures of these chapters, we have studied about the inside our earth means interior or structure of the earth and rocks and its types. So today we are going to start our third lectures with the rock cycle and uses of minerals and uses of rocks. So but students, before starting the today's topic, first we will recapitulate our previous lectures in brief. So let's start. Yes, friends, yesterday we studied about rock. Rock is a natural mass of mineral matter makes up the earth crust. And we have studied that there are mainly three types of rocks: igneous rocks, sedimentary rocks, and metamorphic rocks. Yes, now we will study about these rocks in brief. Yes, igneous rocks. Igneous rocks are formed during volcanic eruption activities. When the molten magma comes out on the earth's surface, it rapidly cools down and becomes solid. So the rocks which are formed in this way on the crust are known as extrusive igneous rocks. Actually, we have studied about the two types of igneous rocks, extrusive and intrusive. So means when the molten lava comes on the earth's surface and rapidly cools down and becomes solid. So means the rocks which are found on the outer crust of the earth's surface, these are known as extrusive igneous rocks. Second type is there, that is intrusive. It means inside. Means sometimes the molten magma cools down deep inside the earth's crust. So the rocks which are formed in this process are actually known as intrusive igneous rocks. So understood the difference? Means the rocks which are found or formed on the outer part, means on the earth's surface, they are extrusive, and which are formed inside the earth crust, they are intrusive igneous rocks. Second one is there, that is sedimentary rocks. Yes, students, sedimentary rocks are the rocks which are formed with the sediments, means broken pieces of rocks, and these sediments are transported and deposited by wind and water on the oceanic crust. Means sedimentary rocks are found on the oceanic crust. And third one is metamorphic rocks. Given the igneous and sedimentary rocks are subjected to heat and pressure, they change into metamorphic rocks. So these are the three types of rocks. Now give a look on this picture here. The pictures is describing or showing the three types of rocks. First is igneous, sedimentary, and metamorphic rocks. Now students, we will discuss about the rock cycle, means how these rocks are formed. Give a look on the diagram. First, look on the top. There is a volcano. So beta, everybody knows that during the volcanic eruption activities, molten magma comes out on the earth's surface, and sometimes some part or amount of the magma remain inside the earth. So when this molten magma cools down, it becomes hard and take the shape or form of rocks. So the rocks which are formed due to the volcanic eruption activities are known as igneous rocks. Okay, so means these igneous rocks are means broken into small sediments due to the action of wind and water, which is known as weathering process. So what is weathering process? Actually, weathering process is the process in which the upper layer of the rocks is removed by the action of water and wind. So means these igneous rocks are broken into, means the upper layer of the igneous rocks are broken into small sediments, fragments which are known as sediments, and these sediments are transported and deposited by the wind and water to any other place. and sometimes when the rivers flow, they carry down a large amount of pieces of rocks, clay and many other material with them, and they deposit it on the ocean crust. Okay, so means on the ocean currents, these sediments, they are compacted and become hardened, and in this way means they deposit over one over another, and after some times that they cemented, compacted and form layers. So in this way the rocks which are formed, these are sedimentary rocks, and due to the heat and pressure or subjected or compacted, after some times these sedimentary rocks change into metamorphic rocks. So beta, due to the heat and pressure inside the earth, these metamorphic rocks again that gets in the molten form, okay, and liquid form, and through the volcanic eruption activities, again this material reaches on the earth surface during volcanic eruption activity, and again the igneous rocks are formed when this magma cools down and becomes hard. So in this way beta, one cycle is going on, and this is known as rock cycle, and this is the formation of rocks. Understood? Yes. Now rock formation, in this we have studied about the four steps. One is weathering, second is transportation, deposition, compactions and the cementations. This is their weathering. Just I told you that weathering is the process in which the upper layer of the rocks are removed by the action of water and wind, and in this way sediments are formed. And see, these sediments or the small particles of the rocks, they are transported and deposited. First they are transported by the action of wind and water, and they are deposited to any other place. These sediments are deposited one over another, and they form a layer when they are compacted and hardens, and in this way the rocks are formed. Understood? Yes. Now the features of rocks, they can be as hard as granite and as soft as clay. Means the rocks can be so much hard also and so much soft also. They are found in different colors, size and shapes, and there are varieties of rocks found on the earth crust. Already we have studied about the three types of rocks. Now uses of rocks. Yes students, like as we know, the rocks contains minerals, metals, and these things are used in our day-to-day life. Like the rocks are used, the material which we get from the rocks, it is used in the constructions, like to set up buildings or making roads and many other things also. They are used as a fire also, means as a fuel like coal, and it is an example of sedimentary origin. We use that rocks are also used, the materials of the rocks are also used for writing. An example is like chalk. Yes or no? Yes, statues, ornaments, decorations which are made up of marble, that is also an example of rock. Gold, diamond, silver, these some are the valuable sources of minerals. And some rocks are very famous, or you can say as a tourist attraction also. So in this way rocks are very useful for us. Now our next topic is mineral. Yes students, mineral. Mineral is a naturally occurring substance that has a definite chemical compositions, and minerals are evenly distributed over space. They are concentrated a particular area or rock formation. Yes or no? Yes means some minerals are found in a particular rock or ore. Some minerals found in areas which are not easily accessible, such as the Arctic Ocean bed, Antarctic Ocean, since many minerals are found in this bed of these oceans, but they are not easily accessible to us. And minerals are formed in different types of geological environments under varying conditions, and they created by natural processes, means without any human interference. And they can be identified on the basis of physical property, their color, their hardness, their solubility and their luster, means shine. Yes, now we will give a look on the uses of minerals. Yes students, minerals are the backbone of all industries. Yes or no? Means they used in many industries, and some minerals are used like to making jewelries. Okay, minerals which are used for gems are usually hard, and these are then set in the various styles of jewelries. Copper. Copper is the another metal. That means iron and copper are used in almost everything, and that copper is another metal which is used in everything, like from coins to pipes. Silicon. This is also used in computer industries. Aluminium, obtained from its ore bauxite, is used in automobiles, airplanes due to its lightweight, bottling industries, building, and even in kitchen cookware. So means these minerals are very useful in our day-to-day life. They are very useful to mankind. Now in this way our chapter is completed, and in this chapter we have studied about the three main topics, you can say, that is the interior or structure of the earth, rocks and its types, and rock cycles and their uses and uses of. So students, now on this basis I am giving you, assigning you some homework. So note down the homework. First you have, first question is that it is your NCERT book question, explain the rock cycle with the help of diagram. Understood? It means for that you have to make a diagram of the rock cycle and by giving explanation. And next is also your NCERT book question, what are the uses of rocks? And these two questions, extra questions which I am giving you, but these topics we have studied in our lecture, right? The uses of minerals and what are fossils. So understood students? Yes. Now we will discuss about our yesterday homework. Yes, yesterday I have given you some questions to do. Now we will discuss the answer of this question. First question, rock. What is rock? A rock is a natural mass of mineral matter that makes up the earth's crust, and rocks can be of different colors, size and texture. Second question was there, beta, how are extrusive and intrusive rocks formed? We have studied that igneous rocks are of two types, extrusive and intrusive. And when the molten lava comes on the earth's surface, it rapidly cools down and become solids. So the rocks formed in this way on the crust are the example of extrusive rocks. And sometimes the molten magma cools down deep inside the earth's crust. And in this way the rocks which are formed, they are known as intrusive igneous rock. Means outside on the earth's surface extrusive, inside the earth crust that are intrusive. Got it? Now next question, what are metamorphic rocks? Yes, when the igneous and sedimentary rocks are subjected to heat and pressure, they change into metamorphic rocks. For example, clay. Clay changes into slate due to heat and pressures, and limestone can get changed into marble. Now mention the features of sedimentary rocks. This is our next question. And the features of the sedimentary rocks are like this. They are pores in nature, that's why they can hold oil and gas. As sedimentary rocks are formed on the oceanic crust. So means which type of minerals or material they hold? They hold oil and gas. They contain the most important thing, that is fossil. Yes, friends, fossil. Yesterday I gave this question also, like fossil means the remaining part of dead plants and animals. They show that stratifications, and they are formed by the different processes such as erosion, weathering, transportation, accumulation and sedimentations. So in this way our today's lecture is completed. Tomorrow again we will meet with our next chapter and next lecture. Thank you.